whole jeans split right down the middle, so everything was exposed.
People were just going around a ballroom decapitating each other with axes.
And all of a sudden, Scooby-Doo's with me.
I would definitely go and see, like, the world burning.
I swear I don't follow this.
Wink, wink. He doesn't follow this.
I don't really know who to trust here.
The gym boosts your testosterone, boosts your confidence. That equals more women.
Get in the fucking gym.
So we all know ChatGPT is taking over the world. If you've been following the news or watching TikTok, you know it can do your homework, write your essays, and even compose poems about former presidents. But today I wanted to find out, can ChatGPT help me create a viral YouTube video? So I visited chat.openai.com, logged in with my Google account, and asked ChatGPT to give me funny and entertaining questions to ask strangers for a viral YouTube video. And then I went up to 40 strangers and asked them these questions. Let's see how they responded. I'm here with
Alyssa,
Aaron,
Dana,
Kamil.
Okay, Alyssa, what's the most absurd dream you've ever had?
I had a dream that my high school got attacked by a gang of terrorists.
Huh?
I had a dream that my high school got attacked by a gang of terrorists. And like I was the hero.
Okay, I don't know if you've ever watched Attack on Titan.
I saved everyone, called the police, helped everyone get to safety, and like gunned down the terrorists.
But one time I had a dream where I was fighting Titans.
And it was amazing, to be honest.
That one was pretty crazy.
You never shared this story with the principal, right?
No, I think I would have been kicked out if I did.
I actually just had a crazy dream. I was in like a giant mansion and we were like looking for someone, I don't remember why. And all of a sudden, Scooby-Doo's with me.
I was in a video game, like Left 4 Dead style.
Oh, I know Left 4 Dead.
But yeah. It was monkeys instead of zombies.
We're looking for my cousin, and I don't remember why, but he was like, he was trying to steal like our shoes. So we find him, and he's wearing all of our shoes at once, and it was crazy.
One time I had a dream that was in black and white, and it had captions. It was in the Victorian ages, and people were just going around a ballroom decapitating each other with axes.
Okay, I didn't think it was that scary. Then I heard the decapitating part, and I'm like, oh shit, that's scary. Dude, I like completely forget my dreams the moment I wake up, but you explained that in like very vivid detail.
I started writing them down, and that makes them so much better.
So I had a dream. Forget what it was about. But I woke up from that dream, went back to bed, and then had a dream where I told people about that dream.
Oh my god, that's like Inception. Guys, write down your dreams. What's the weirdest thing you've ever eaten just because you were curious?
One time I went to Vietnam, and they gave us like a $5, so that was something I was very curious about, so I just ate it.
An acorn.
Why? Do you know what type of bug it was?
I have no idea.
No idea?
Might have been a worm or something.
Well, because I thought, well, they're probably edible, so I just found one, and I was looking for acorn, and then I found one, and I ate it.
Did it look like a worm? Like, was it very, like, long and slimy?
No, it was very small and brown.
Small and brown.
And it came in a cup.
Did you enjoy it?
No, it was disgusting.
My disappointment is immeasurable, and my day is ruined.
Could you describe the taste anyway? Was it, like, sweet, salty?
This is a while ago, so I don't really remember. I just remember it being really crispy. It did taste like, you know, what you'd think would be a bug would taste like.
Would you eat it again?
Maybe.
So the weirdest thing I've ever eaten is probably haggis, which is also another Scottish delicacy. I have it here. It's sheep's heart, liver, lungs, and stomach.
I ate a chocolate-covered bug once.
Could we interest you in some chocolate?
I just wanted to know what it would taste like.
And how did it taste?
Not very good.
The chocolate didn't really compensate for the taste of the bug.
It's too crunchy, yeah.
Actually, I asked a person the same question before, and she also said she ate a bug, and she also said it was really crunchy.
Yeah, it was. No, it wasn't good.
Wasn't good?
No, I wouldn't do it again.
2 months ago in my university dorm, Dove CH,
what the fuck?
I had a pickle with mustard covered in a bun.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self one piece of advice, what would it be and why?
For me personally, just to make myself uncomfortable, be okay with putting myself in situations that aren't normal or something I'm not used to. I think that's like the main thing, just being uncomfortable, putting myself out there and just so I can experience something different.
Would you consider this to be one of those uncomfortable situations?
Yeah, definitely. I wasn't expecting this today.
The piece of advice that I would give myself would be to save more money earlier because I am currently broke right now.
I would say to study harder because I don't know. Things just get harder in life.
I'd definitely say get in the gym way fucking earlier. Give yourself 2 hours a day to better yourself, be healthier, and look better, you know? And girls girls fucking love that shit.
Since I've been going to the gym, it's boosted my confidence so much. Mm-hmm. And honestly, without going to the gym, I probably wouldn't even have the confidence to make this video.
And that's because his testosterone is rising through the roof, because the gym boosts your testosterone, boosts your confidence, that equals more women. Get in the fucking gym.
What's the most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to you in public? And please don't say this interview.
Well, one time I was coming off the GO train, and like there was a bunch of people waiting to come on, and I was one of the only people coming off, and as I stepped down, my ankle gave out on me, and I fell over onto this random lady, and like I held on to her for dear life.
But did anyone actually try to help you? Like,
no.
Come on, man.
See, that's what's wrong with people. That's what's wrong with the 21st century.
I was walking down the street and a car sprayed me, and I was on my way to school, so I had to sit in the wet clothes all day.
Actually, one time while I was at work, I was wearing the same jeans I'm wearing right now, and we were having like a little game, a little contest, and it was like pretty much you just had to like bend down and pick something up the fastest, and everyone was standing behind me when we were doing it, and as soon as I went, my whole jeans split right down the middle.
What?
So
everything
was exposed.
What the fuck?
That's like probably the most embarrassing story that I've actually heard so far.
Yeah, it was terrifying.
Wow.
They gave me pants, so.
What was the immediate aftermath of that? Like, how do people react?
Honestly, nobody saw at first, and then I was like, my pants just split, and everybody started laughing. I was like, what the actual fuck?
It made you memorable, don't worry.
Yeah, for real. Everybody knows me now.
Did it result in a promotion?
Not yet, but coming soon, maybe.
Coming soon.
Have to update.
Stay tuned.
I was at a Toronto Maple Leafs game, and I was on TV, so they were showing people in the stands, but I wasn't paying attention, and the angle I was at, it kind of looked like I was like picking my nose, but I wasn't. And then I had all my friends like blow me up on Instagram saying they saw me on TV on the Leafs game, and they all thought I was picking my nose. So it was a rough day at school the next day, so.
Oh my God, I've seen those videos where it's like, they do like the kiss cam or whatever, and there's like a guy that's totally oblivious.
Yeah.
I feel like picking your nose is even worse though. That's gotta suck.
It was tough, yeah.
I'd say the most embarrassing thing that's happened to me public would be in elementary school. So going a little bit way back, I was sick and I showed up to school, and just in the middle of class, I felt like I was going to throw up. So how it started was I went to the trash can at the door, and then I had to go to the washroom. What ended up happening is I left a trail of vomit from the classroom all the way to the girls' washroom. And let me just say, like, I didn't show up to school for a week. Everyone was talking about it, and my best friend was like, don't worry, it's just food. She was spilling food, but it was really vomit the whole time. And yeah, it was a mess.
Those kind of like videos came again. I don't follow like these types of pages, but I don't know why they just showed up, and got embarrassing.
It was just the algorithm somehow decided.
Sure, he doesn't follow them. Yeah. I doesn't.
I swear I don't follow this.
Wink, wink.
I swear.
I did not have sexual relations.
If you could time travel to any point in history, what event or period would you choose to witness firsthand, and why?
I guess the Jurassic period, because I love dinosaurs and I've always wanted to study them, so I think that'd be a fun thing for me to do.
What made you so interested in dinosaurs, man?
Honest to God, Jurassic Park.
I'd probably like go back to like the Jurassic age and like witness the world ending type shit. You know what I mean? Like all the asteroids and stuff like destroying the Earth.
Fast. No.
No, but like it's an experience. You know what I mean?
Experience.
I would definitely go and see like the world burning.
You know, someone else said the Jurassic period. I don't really think they mentioned the world burning part. So that's unique.
I want to see the T-Rexes vibe out and shit for a bit.
That's
but once that gets
awesome.
boring, I just want to see the world end.
You want to see when the meteorite strikes down, right?
Yeah.
Kills all the dinosaurs.
I would definitely go towards the future, I would say, because I think it would be interesting to see like how technology develops.
That's really interesting.
Yeah.
All the answers so far have been of the past, but he's saying to go to the future.
I just want to see, you know, like how people live, how, you know, simple things like houses, cars work.
Do you have any prediction for what's going to change in the next 50 years?
I would say electric cars would be dominant. I think that would be the primary method of transportation.
Do you look up to Elon Musk?
Not a lot, to be honest.
If you had to wear a t-shirt with one word on it for a year, what word would you choose?
I would choose the word uninterested so that people would leave me alone and I could go about my day.
Probably kindness, just like spread kindness around.
Do you have any specific examples of like what you would do?
Like with kindness?
Yeah, yeah.
Like I work right there, and like all about that work is just to spread. Like we give money to like students if they can't pay for like things in our grocery store down there.
Oh, okay.
So like it's just all about like helping people, like just spreading kindness.
Like helping the needy. And
basically, helping students especially.
I would choose Friday because Fridays are the best.
I totally agree with that message. I approve of this message. What is the most ridiculous thing you've done to impress someone?
I once climbed a tree because their sweater was up about like 9 floors up. So I had to climb and grab it for them.
What do you think is the meaning of life and how do you strive to live in accordance with that meaning?
I think the meaning of life is finding spontaneous moments like this one and making the most out of it. So like meaning of life is it's a world full of chaos and just like kind of making your own path out of like when things just kind of happen spontaneously.
So you heard it. I asked a bunch of strangers questions generated by ChatGPT and the responses were pretty epic.
I had a dream that my high school got attacked by a gang of terrorists.
Now the only question that remains is, will this video go viral? ChatGPT has done its part, now it's time for you to decide. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and please, 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 please send it to your friends and family. DM them right now. If you're a college student like me, send it to your prof. I don't care, send it to your grandma. And drop a comment if you want to see a part two, because it's a short Asian male interested in tech. I am totally down to harass some more strangers. All right, peace.
I swear I don't follow this.
Wink, wink.
I swear.